Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off today's video, there was a tweet posted by OneWeb. It says, "We are pleased to announce that we have entered into a launch agreement with SpaceX that will enable OneWeb to resume satellite launches. The first launch with SpaceX is anticipated later this year." There was a tweet posted by Michael Sheets saying quality analytics found that US space companies are poised to benefit from Russia cutting itself off from much of the global space industry, with SpaceX the clear winner in the launch market, exemplified this morning by OneWeb's new deal. There were some tweets posted in response to this from Musk, with the first one saying SpaceX default plan was approximately 65% of global launch mass to orbit this year. Incremental demand might take that to approximately 70%, so not a major change. Those numbers don't count Starship. Rest of world is less than 400 tons, mostly China. There is some information which could mean SpaceX might get some more missions to launch. Eric Berger posted a tweet saying, "Notable important space officials in Germany say the best course for Europe in the near term would be to move six stranded Galileo satellites which had been due to fly on Soyuz to three Falcon 9 rockets." He also posted saying this will almost certainly be resisted by France-based Arianespace. However, it may ultimately be necessary because there are no Ariane 5 cores left and the new Ariane 6 rocket is unlikely to have capacity for a couple of years. There was an article posted about SpaceX cutting ties with one of the companies they launch satellites for. It says SpaceX is severing ties with launch services company Spaceflight Inc. after 4 years of working closely together, a move that surprised spaceflight executives. Further to this, the article also says, "We were surprised to learn of it on Friday and were not given any insight into the reasoning behind the decision," Jody Sorensen, Spaceflight Marketing Vice President, said by email. "We continue to reach out to SpaceX in an attempt to discuss their position but haven't heard back yet." There was an interesting article posted saying Swarm Technologies was the unidentified customer of an Astrospace launch this month that placed 16 of its tiny satellites into orbit. Now, what's interesting about this news is that Swarm Technologies was acquired by SpaceX back in 2021. There was another article posted, with this one being about Starlink and price increases. It says SpaceX has raised prices for both its Starlink broadband service and for dedicated and rideshare launches, in some cases by up to 20%, citing inflation. The cost of the service, which had been $99 in the United States, increased 11% to $110. The terminal, which cost $499 in the US, increased to $549 for those who had already paid a deposit and $599 for new customers, the latter a 20% increase. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site where there was some testing recently. Propellant deliveries have recently been spotted to the orbital tank farm. The structural test stand was moved to the launch site. The work on the wide bay and the production yard has been continuing. Here's a view of how the wide bay is looking overall next to the high bay. In the thread stemming from Michael Sheets' tweet, Musk posted some information about Starship. He said, "First Starship orbital flight will be with Raptor 2 engines, as they are much more capable and reliable. 230-ton or approximately 500,000-pound thrust at sea level. We'll have 39 flight-worthy engines built by next month, then another month to integrate, so hopefully May for orbital flight test." In response, Musk was asked, "Will Starship SN20 and Super Heavy Booster 4 still conduct the orbital flight or new prototypes?" He responded and said, "New. This new booster common dome was recently flipped in the yard. There was a new booster upper bulkhead sleeved with its ring stack in the yard. After being destacked last week, Starship 20 has now been moved away from the chopsticks. Here's a view of Ship 24 currently being worked on in the mid bay. This Ship 25 mid liquid oxygen ring stack was seen outside. Amid some fog, Super Heavy Booster 4 has undergone some testing this week. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, the closures are mostly irrelevant, with today and tomorrow having been cancelled. There is still a date scheduled for Friday 25th though. Some aero covers known as chines have been installed over Booster 7's COPVs. This barrel section for a test tank, which will be B7.1, was spotted. As always, I have to say thank you to both Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, and Nick Antsuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.